Hey guys, so MediaTek has done some amazing work in mobile chipsets. It has already announced its MediaTek 1000 SoC for flagship smartphones, and in December, Oppo announced the Oppo Reno 3 with the Dimensity 1000L SoC. Although as of now, the difference between the Dimensity 1000 and 1000L are unknown. Now, the Taiwanese OEM seeks to cover the premium mid-range sector of the same market with the new 800 series and is in direct competition with the Snapdragon mid-range 5G chipsets. The Dimensity 800 is a mid-range solution with integrated 5G mode that is designed to bring dual-mode 5G capabilities to low-priced smartphones. So now, let's continue with our comparison. First, let me tell you, both are built on 7nm process. As for CPU, the MediaTek Dimensity 800 has 4 big ARM Cortex-A76 cores clocked at up to 2GHz, paired with 4 little ARM Cortex-A55 cores clocked at up to 2GHz. Whereas Qualcomm Snapdragon 765 has a prime core that goes up to 2.3GHz and another performance core that reaches 2.2GHz. The 6 Cortex-A55 based efficiency cores are clocked at up to 1.8GHz. Both are not using the newer flagship ARM Cortex-A77 core, but this is what differentiates the flagships from the mid-range, at least on MediaTek and Snapdragon. In conclusion, MediaTek is having more performance cores, meaning it will improve app and game launch times and improves multi-threaded performance as well. So all in all, MediaTek has this round in pocket. In terms of GPU performance, the Dimensity 800 has 4 cores of ARM's Mali-G77. The graphic unit is the same class as the one in the Dimensity 1000 with fewer cores. And for Snapdragon 765 chipset, it gets Adreno 620 GPU. I don't actually know how well Mali-G77 will perform with 4 cores, so we will consider this as a draw, or you can decide for yourself which one is better. When it comes to AI, MediaTek CPU 3.0 has 4 cores consisting of 3 different core types in its design, and this enables the Dimensity 800 to provide up to 2.4 TOPS, that is, tera operations per second of AI performance. Whereas Snapdragon 765 chipset features the Hexagon 696 DSP, upgrading it from the Hexagon 688 on Snapdragon 730. The 5th generation AI engine on Snapdragon 765 offers 5.5 TOPS. So in AI tasks, Snapdragon 765 is better than MediaTek 800 SoC. The company proclaims Dimensity 800 as a flagship level image signal processor, and it supports up to 4 cameras with support for 64 megapixel images or dual cameras of 32+16MP with AI capabilities. As for Snapdragon 765, the Spectra 350 ISP allows the chipset to support single camera of up to 192MP and dual cameras of 22+22MP. It also supports multi-cameras. Coming to display, the Dimensity 800 series supports Full HD Plus display with refresh rate of up to 90Hz, whereas the on-device resolution on Snapdragon 765 powered phones will support Quad HD Plus with 60Hz refresh rate and Full HD Plus resolution with 120Hz refresh rate. The new processor touts the Helio M70 integrated 5G modem with sub 6GHz support. Don't expect mmWave 5G here though, much like the flagship Dimensity 1000. While support for millimeter wave 5G is absent, this doesn't matter as much as it seems because mmWave 5G is only a reality in US for now. Japan and South Korea will also have mmWave 5G networks this year. The Dimensity 1000 isn't intended for such markets. The modem enables download speeds of 3.5 Gbps and upload speeds of 1.25 Gbps. But unlike the flagship chipset, the Dimensity 800 doesn't pack 5G plus 5G dual SIM support. On the other hand, the Snapdragon 765 is integrated with X52 5G modem that promises 3.7 Gbps 5G download speeds and 1.6 Gbps 5G upload speeds over sub 6GHz and mmWave. And on 4G LTE, the downlink is 1.2 Gbps and uplink is 210 Mbps. On paper, the MediaTek SoC seems to be a strong competitor to the Qualcomm Snapdragon 765 and 765G, as it will likely have a better CPU performance and a competitive GPU implementation. But this falls behind in some tasks. But where MediaTek lacks the most is in the developer support. I think this will change soon enough if MediaTek continue to perform same way. So this was the quick comparison of Snapdragon 765 and MediaTek 800 chipset. So if you like what you saw, then do consider subscribing. Again, thank you for watching this video. Peace out.